wanted to talk about my 2 week weight symptoms. So I got this new yakisoba. It's different. It comes with 3 packets of noodles in it and 3 packets of the same seasoning. It's interesting seasoning. It smells like cloves and ginger, things like that. I did add my sauces to it as well, because I was afraid of just having that flavor, so I only used one of its packets because obviously I was concerned about like the flavor being too different for me. So yes, dishes are all like dirty, so I'm using plastic, which I typically wouldn't, but this is the only option, so that's what I'm doing. Yep. There's my din din. So, obviously, I took a pregnancy test today. If it'll focus again, that'd be nice. There we go. I think that's pretty obviously negative. I thought I saw a little something earlier, but I guess not. Anyway, I guess ovulation test. There it is. Very negative. Yep. I don't know. It's not looking great for me this cycle, I guess. Not my cycle again. Yeah. Part of my breakfast. I smushed half an avocado onto these 3 halves of pita bread. And then I did a little bit of that vegan ranch, and it is a little watered down. I always water my ranch down. But that's part of my breakfast. I'll also be having a smoothie here in a while. Yep. So, this is cycle day 27. I did get a negative pregnancy test. When I hold it up a certain way, I think I see something, but I've had this happen before, so I refuse to get my hopes up until I see something I don't have to hold just right. But all the other tests I took, they were completely negative no matter what lighting I put them under or how I held them. You know, us TTCers and our just the right angles and all that stuff, so I wanted to talk about my 2 week weight symptoms. If they're symptoms at all, I mean, they could just be PMS, could just be, I don't even know what. But first thing I noticed right after I ovulated was TMI alert. It stayed very wet, like I still had the egg white CM, so that took a while to go away. Very, very wet. Moving on, another thing I noticed right after I got that positive test, like the very next day, I started to feel really exhausted. I don't know if that was just from having an actual hormonal shift that I couldn't feel, because, you know, when you don't ovulate, you probably don't have that steep hormone shift. So I'm sure that's all that was. Since then, also, because before I ovulated, I was able to get the treadmill all the way up on incline and not hold on, and I didn't have to hold on the whole time. And since then, I've gone and I just randomly feel out of balance, like I'm gonna get dizzy and fall, that kind of feeling. So I have to hang on. Like, I can't just go the whole time without holding on like I usually can. And I feel like I'm out of breath easy. I don't know. Without a positive pregnancy test, it's all just like, whatever. Could be allergies, could be asthma, could be fibro, you know, could just be that I had an actual hormonal shift and, I don't know. Last couple nights, I've randomly gotten like weird pinches in my uterus that aren't normal for me. I'm gonna add that on to the list of symptoms. Could just be that my cycle did just get longer. Last cycle was 30 days. It's been an average of 27 days for like 3 years. So, but then last time that my cycle shifted to 30 days, I got pregnant with Luke. So I have a lot of hope for that too, based on that, and based on actually getting a positive ovulation test. It was unmistakable, undeniable. The ones I thought were positive, you know, because right away the test line looked darker, or dark as the control line, but once it got, like, settled, it wasn't. But the cycle day 14 p.m. was. So, I think if that is accurate of like, okay, so then 2 weeks after that, so Friday or Saturday, I can expect my period, because it's 2 weeks after, or is it something like 2 weeks after your ovulation you get your period? I don't know, I might be remembering that wrong. I haven't, like, dwelled on things like that, because, I don't know, hoping every cycle I don't get my period. So, I guess if I don't get my period Saturday, I'll be late on Sunday. But if I do, I start a new cycle. Anything else? I have been devastatingly exhausted. Whether I get enough sleep, a normal amount of sleep, or just under what sleep I think I should be getting, I'm exhausted. I'm freaking exhausted. I, like, don't want to work out. I don't want to clean. I don't want to take my dogs anywhere. I'm pathetic right now. I don't know why. Like I said, that could be allergies, asthma, my fibro, whatever, but it's something worth noting, because it is how I felt before I found out I was pregnant with Luke. All of a sudden I was so tired that I just laid around all the time. If I didn't have anything to do, I was laying around, laying down. Like, I didn't lay down as much back then. But all of a sudden, around just before I was supposed to get my period, I was so tired that I just couldn't barely do anything. I switched from exercising twice a day to only once, if once. So, I think I left school early a couple times because I was so tired, because I went to night school for personal training then. It's just, I was like, not feeling good. So, this is similar to that. I'm not saying I think it's a definite sign. It could be. And I don't know if there's anything else. My nipples are always sensitive, but they, I don't know. So that's probably not, because they've been sensitive constantly. So I think that's it. Oh well, I'll keep you posted on whether this like turns into anything, or I'll let you know my cycle started, another cycle. It would be like my 36th or 37th cycle. Mind you, it's not been 3 years yet, but I had an average of 27-day cycle, so I had more cycles than months, obviously. But I'm just gonna count it as almost 3 years so far. But this is really long, so I'm just gonna go ahead and end my vlog for today because it's getting long already with this. Thank you so much for all the support. Thank you to all my subscribers. If you haven't done so, please hit the subscribe button. And if you like this video, or if you're TTCing, hit the like. Have a good day, and God bless you.